Before getting started with ICAT, you'll need to make sure your QuickBooks chart of accounts is properly configured for government contracting. In this video, we'll review how to set up your chart of accounts to calculate indirect rates, allocate indirect costs, and generate reports within ICAT. Your chart of accounts should be organized to reflect your indirect cost allocation policy. This policy defines your indirect rate structure, including your indirect cost pools. If you don't have an indirect cost allocation policy, examples of common indirect rate structures are available in the ICAT user guide. ICAT identifies your cost pools according to the account hierarchy in your QuickBooks chart of accounts. ICAT recognizes any cost of goods sold or expense type account that sits at the root level of the parent account, sub-account hierarchy as a cost pool. Each cost pool in your cost allocation policy, whether it is a direct, an indirect, or an unallowable cost pool, must be identified using a parent-level account. There should be only one top-level account for each cost pool. Each transaction account within a cost pool must be a sub-account of the parent-level account that identifies the cost pool. Let's look at a sample chart of accounts. We have a parent-level cost of goods sold account for direct costs, and we have sub-accounts for direct labor, direct subcontracts, direct travel, direct materials, and other direct costs. All of our transaction level accounts are subordinated to that direct cost pool account. The same hierarchy applies for all of our indirect accounts and our unallowable cost pool. Our indirect cost pool for fringe benefits has a parent level expense type account to identify the fringe benefits cost pool and subgroups for our compensated absences, group benefits, and payroll taxes. Each subgroup consists of various transaction level accounts subordinated under each of these subaccounts for costs within the fringe benefits cost pool. ICAT accommodates any number of indirect cost pools in any structure using this parent account subaccount hierarchy. If you have an existing chart of accounts, you should review your account hierarchy to make sure your cost pools follow this parent account subaccount hierarchy. Your chart of accounts may require some reconfiguring before you can set up ICAT. If you are just getting started with QuickBooks and you do not have a chart of accounts, ICAT includes a feature to generate a chart of accounts that is pre-formatted for a government contractor. ICAT's company setup wizard will save you time when setting up a new company file, but should never be used when you already have a chart of accounts. Once you have the chart of accounts set up to reflect your cost pool structure, you can begin setting up ICAT.